Good morning, everyone, here in person and joining us on Zoom. And of course, as we say every week, welcome to Chesterland UCC. And as we say in the UCC, wherever you are on life's journey, you are absolutely welcome here as you are. Okay, well, if you didn't hear, the individual who unfortunately attempted to burn our church down pled guilty this past week to two of the more severe charges he was facing, one of them being the federal hate crime statute. He will be facing sentencing in January. It's probably most likely going to be a minimum of 20 years around there, probably 15 to 20 years from what I have been told. Also, there will be an opportunity for victim impact statements if anyone would like to do that. I just received an envelope today with forms that we can fill out. If you yourself would like to do a victim impact statement, you can just write one out. Or if you would like to go to the sentencing hearing and say a few words, you can do that as well. I will be attending the sentencing hearing and I'll be saying a few words there. But if you don't want to go, you can write something, or you don't have to do anything at all. But I just want to let you all know that that is an option. But having said that, today's moment of focus is two letters that came into the church after the news of the plea was released in the news. And the first letter is from a woman named Laura White, who wrote the following. I was writing to tell you that I really respect how accepting and loving you guys are of LGBTQ plus people. A church that loving is hard to find. You guys give me hope for the Christian faith, especially recently with how hate crimes are rising. I've said for a long time that there are people who are Christians and people who believe God exists. You guys are the Christians, with just as much love in your hearts as Jesus himself. I'm an atheist and have been for about half my life so far, but it's people like you that make me want to sit in the pews anyway. Thank you and keep loving others, Laura White. The second letter is from someone a few of you might know, a former minister here at Chesterland. His name is Reverend David Holden, and he wrote the following. Dear Pastor Peacock and friends in Chesterland, this morning I read with both shock and great sorrow the news about the attempted firebombing of Community Church of Chesterland. While I thank God that the attempt was unsuccessful and that no one was injured, I weep at the brokenness of our world, that Community Church's compassionate ministry of extravagant Christian welcome should generate such a violent and hate-filled response. While I know that often behind such acts lies an irrational fear, this incident painfully reminds us of how deeply such fears not only divide, but damage us as a people. Know that I remember my Chesterland church family fondly, that I continue to pray for your safety, for blessings upon your prophetic witness and joyous community, and for justice, peace, and reconciliation among all the people in the midst of the whole creation that God created, sustains, and redeems even now. In the spirit of Jesus, who taught us to pray for God's reign to come on earth as it is in heaven, peace be with you, Pastor David, Minister of Outreach and Involvement, Second Presbyterian Church, Lexington, Kentucky.
Precious Lord, take my hand, lead me on, let me stand. I am tired, I am weak, I am worn. Through the storm, through the night, lead me on to the light. Take my hand, precious Lord, lead me home. When my way grows drear, precious Lord, linger near. When my life is almost gone, cry, hear my call, hold my hand lest I fall. Take my hand, precious Lord, lead me home. When the shadows appear and the night draws near and the day is past and gone, at the river I stand, guide my feet, hold my hand, take my hand, precious Lord, lead me home.
This is the time in our gathering where we extend the invitation to you to take part in the life of the church through the act of giving. If you feel so led as to share your resources with Chesterland UCC, you can do that online with the QR code that is in your bulletin. You can snail mail it if you like, or there is a little bowl on the back table on your way out if you just want to drop it in there. And with that, would you please join me in prayer for our offering blessing today? Sacred Presence, you are no stranger to our worries and our concerns, whether those be related to world events or personal strife. But we can know that through community, we come to know that your care is steady, abiding, and enduring. We give you thanks and ask for the faith to be patient in times filled with just so much chaos and fear. May your compassion and love be our firm foundation. May it be so. Amen. Today's scripture passage is from the Hebrew Bible, the book of Amos, chapter 5, verses 21 through 24, and I am reading from the Inclusive Bible. This is Yahweh speaking. I despise and reject your feasts. I am not appeased by your solemn assemblies. When you offer me burnt offerings, I reject your oblations and refuse to look at your sacrifices of fattened cattle. Spare me the racket of your chanting. Relieve me of the strumming of your harps. Instead, let justice flow like a river and righteousness flow like an unfailing stream. So I was in the middle of writing this week's message, which was going to be on poverty and homelessness, and barring anything else horrible happening this week in the world, that will probably be the theme next Sunday. But in the midst of putting together this message is when I first got the news of the horrifying news of another senseless mass shooting, this time in Lewiston, Maine. And I always struggle when something massive is going on in the world and a pastor does nothing to address it during a service, as if our culture of gun violence and the horrors taking place in Israel and Palestine don't affect us. So I set the message I was working on aside, and today we will be engaging together in a call and response ritual as a way of helping us to hopefully in some small way process not only the shocking violence in Maine, but the ongoing devastation overseas as well. The words of your call and response will be on the screen, but they are also in your bulletin if you prefer that. Your parts are in red, and I will be saying those parts as well so we don't get lost or anything. But I genuinely hope that the next few minutes as we do this together, like I said, in some small way, are valuable to your spirit. So let's begin. The beloved be with you.
And also with you.
When the world's deep wounds remind us how precious but fragile life is, we remember that our lives depend on one another. The divine spirit is here, sharing in our longings, bearing witness to our laments. God does not abandon us. The creator and birther of life has set the world in motion in a perfect harmony, but in our arrogance and fear, we have turned to grasping at every opportunity for greed and control we can muster. We have undone the balance of life and traded it for a false sense of power and security. And yet, even still, the compassion of the divine has persisted throughout the ages. In the face of violence, oppression, tyranny, and injustice, the cosmic Christ chose to take on flesh, to not only experience it all with us, but to liberate us into new ways of living and loving. In the person of Jesus, we witnessed love enfleshed. It was vulnerable. It was present. It was courageous. It was unwilling to believe things have to be this way. Jesus, deeply tender towards those whose lives cried out for compassion, showed us how to live in a world where power is imbalanced and violence is common. But in the story of the life, death, and resurrection of Jesus, we are reminded that violence and death never have the last word. Life persists, hope persists, love persists. God, how many times must we cry out, how long? How many times will the cycles of violence repeat themselves? Headline after headline, the news of lives lost to gun violence repeats itself. Heartbreak, reaction, effort, no change. Heartbreak, reaction, effort, no change. Heartbreak, reaction, effort, no change. When will thoughts and prayers become policy and progress? In Amos, you tell your people that you are sick of our chanting, you're sick of our prayers, you're sick of our assemblies, of playing church. What you desire is justice. And so, when will justice guide our conversations on gun violence rather than greed, rather than political gamesmanship? Divine Spirit, hear our cries. Open your ears to our lament. Weep with us when we weep. Listen, we are calling to you. In the person of Jesus, you walked a world where the powerful were not held accountable, the poor were made vulnerable, and violence was used as a tool of fear and control. Though there were no guns, the same spirits of destruction and fear hovered over life. You know the grief we bear. For the victims of preventable gun violence, we are filled with mourning. For the dead and injured in Lewiston, Maine, our hearts are broken. For the community and people of Lewiston who, like too many communities anymore, must find a way to move forward through trauma and fear, we confess we have not done enough to protect them. For the families of those dead and injured, bring your justice, O God. For the spirit of fear that hovers over our daily lives, inviting us to wonder, are we safe here? In our church, in our schools, in our streets. Be our place of refuge, O God. Divine Presence, we wonder what it will take for meaningful change to occur. Wherever there is inaction, put your people into motion. Let no heart be settled, no mind be at peace that has the ability to make a positive change but chooses inaction instead. For all the harm that has been done and for that which is still to come, may your spirit provoke repentance. Forgive us our complacency and lead us on paths of justice. Not even the violence and devastation of machines of war can overcome the power of your love. So rise within us and around us, Divine Spirit, that your kingdom may come on earth as it is in heaven. Not someday, but today. Fill all your people who are committed to resistance with strength and courage, and ground them in assurance that in bearing testament to justice and love and the sanctity of human life, that you are there also. Hold tenderly all who are afraid. Weep with all whose hearts are ripped open by each act of violence or injustice, whether gun violence, terrorism, or war crimes enacted by a state power. Rage with those who wish to tear down every word, structure, and symbol of a society existing on an endless matrix of violence and fear. Give us each the discernment to hear what you would have us to do today and every day going forward until all your people are free. Would you please join me in prayer or meditation? Divine Presence, the world is full of the wonderful as well as the unspeakable. But these days, hope is hard to find when we are constantly confronted by stories of gun violence, of loss of life, of war, yet another seemingly safe space being terrorized, and of political institutions doing nothing in response. We are left wondering where to turn. Beloved, meet us in the middle of all of it, inviting us not to turn away from the sadness or allow ourselves to become numb to the injustices, but to dwell in the midst of it. Your presence gives us a space to pause, to break the cycle of violence, media coverage, and then moving on. In you, we are invited to be present to the pain of the world, to the parts of it we hold in our own bodies, and to honor the lives taken or affected by our ongoing waking nightmare of gun violence. Give to us the courage to remain soft in this hard world. May it be so. Amen.
Imagine there's no heaven. It's easy if you try. No hell below us. Above us only sky. Imagine all the people living for today. Imagine there's no countries. It isn't hard to do. Nothing to kill or die for, no religion to. Imagine all the people living life in peace. You may say I'm a dreamer, but I'm not the only one. I hope someday you'll join us, and the world will be as one. Thank you. Imagine no possessions. I wonder if you can. No need for greed or hunger. A brotherhood of man. Imagine all the people sharing all the world. You may say I'm a dreamer, but I'm not the only one. I hope someday you'll join us, and the world will live as one. You may say I'm a dreamer, but I'm not the only one. I hope someday you'll join us, and the world will live as one.
It's my favorite holiday of the year. I do love Halloween very, very much. As you, my little prayer skeletons up here. So I brought these. So this one's praying, this one's meditating. And the reason I brought these was because if we were going to have kids, I was going to do a children's message on skeletons, right? And that, you know, we all have skeletons and they all look the same, right? We're all the same inside. None of us are different. Unless you're like an X-Man and you don't have bones, you're like gooey or something like that. I don't know. But we all have skeletons and we're all the same, and we need to start acting accordingly that we are all the same. So, yes. So you got a children's message. There you go.
Long restraint. Give peace, oh God. Give peace again. Remember, God, your works of old, the wonders that our people told. Heal every malice, harm, and pain. Give peace, O God, give peace again. Whom shall we trust, O God, but you? For you are constant, strong, and true. None ever called you in vain. Give peace, O God, give peace again.
Rush past loss of life or to normalize fear and violence. So go, knowing whenever your grief or anger or fear returns, God is there with you. Go in the peace and courage of having named the truth of what is, but as we bear witness to what can be. May it be so. Amen.